But let me go to our guest. I'm delighted to have Congressman Jeff Fortenberry with us from the 1st Congressional District of Nebraska. And this is a man who knows a lot about a topic that is not discussed enough. And that's the status and the future of our Christian brothers and sisters in the Middle East. Congressman Fortenberry, are you with us?
Dr. Goricker, yes, pleasure to speak with you. Thanks so much for having me on.
Absolutely, absolutely. This is such an important story that we don't cover adequately. What is the status? Can you give an update to the listeners here on the Dennis Prager Show of what is the plight of the Christians in the Middle East after the last 17 years?
Decimated, diminished, hanging on by a thread. First of all, let me thank you so much for your willingness to raise consciousness about this issue. And it's important to us all. It should be important to everyone in the world, no matter if you're a Christian or of other religious faith tradition, because what this is about is the principles of civilization itself. If you lose the ancient minorities or ancient religious minority tradition in the Middle East, you really have no prospects for long-term peace. You undermine the principle of pluralism, the respect for the sacred space of human dignity, which is the exercise of the right of conscience from which religious liberty flows. And so we all are very familiar with what's happened in the last few years, particularly with the dark, twisted theology of ISIS, which targeted Christians and Yazidis and other faith minorities for extermination. And they've been pretty successful, both in terms of their killing, but also the forcing of these ancient traditions to flee. If I could for a moment, if you give me a moment.
We have a minute left. What's the most important thing the listeners need to know, Congressman?
First of all, the United States is diverting some funds into the rebuilding of the community structure in the northern part of Iraq. This is important for humanitarian purposes. It's very important as well for the future securitization and the possibilities, again, of long-term peace in the Middle East, a healthy form of nationalism, if you will, that respects pluralism. But third, it also decreases migration pressure. So many of these ancient faith traditions have fled to the Kurdish areas, Lebanon, some in Syria, some in Turkey, some in Jordan. But to be able to establish a foothold again of the proper flourishing of these communities, as long as there's securitization, create the conditions for long-term stability there and a proper form of nationalism. And this is also coming from major Arab leaders as well. So we've got a role to play, a special role to play in Iraq. We just don't sit around while other people die. That's who we are. That's our impulse as Americans. But given our entanglements in Iraq, as well as the pressures for migration, reestablishing the prospects for these communities, which is only right and just, is critical to potential stability of the area.
Thank you. You heard it here. We need to help these people. Please follow the Congressman Jeff Fortenberry. That's F-O-R-T-E-N-B-E-R-R-Y. Thank you, Congressman. This is the Dennis Prager Show.